So, you know, any one of us, if we put our minds to it, could easily, and without any disruption to our lifestyle, buy 10% less stuff next year. Right? It'll actually be liberation, less stuff to find somewhere to put, you know, put it all apart from anything else, less credit card debt. So 10% less stuff would be easy to achieve. And yet, who wouldn't like to have 5 more weeks holiday next year? Because that's what the trade-off is. 10% less stuff, 5 weeks more holiday. Right? Now, of course, that requires a certain restructuring in terms of work patterns and so on, but the point is that's the trade-off. So the future looks like less work, right? Less money, right? Less stuff, and a lot more time. Now, the good news is that all the research, the social scientists' research into happiness says very clearly and very consistently across cultures, right, and across time, is that what makes us happy once we have our basic needs met, I emphasise that, once we have our basic needs met, what makes us happy is things like community, right, things like being more involved with people around you, like giving and contributing to your community and doing things with meaning, right, being physically active and fit, right, so being healthy but also being, you know, physically active every day, smelling the roses, taking notice of the world around you, all those things make us happy and make us consistently feel a sense of life satisfaction, and none of those things are available in Walmart. Right? So the point of that is that you can imagine a life very easily where productivity increases, which we have all the time, don't result in more money and more consumption, but result in more time, and more time to do the things that actually make us happy. Remembering that as a great Australian author, Clive Hamilton, who said the basic, all you need to understand about the global economy is that it's built on one simple idea, that is that we all buy stuff we don't need with money we haven't got to impress people we don't like.